Good morning, everybody. Raw Guy here. We're here at the Shore Riders ATV Annual Fish and Chip Poker Rally. It's January 25th. It's a nice balmy, about -8, I think. It's actually supposed to warm up quite a bit today. I got a group of riders in front of me, one including the route styles of Kevin, who is also, you know, on YouTube as Nova Scotia ATV. So please go check out his channel. Hopefully going to have a nice good run today. I was bike number 412. Last year they had some odd hundred or something like that bikes here. So it's bound to be a great big old run, and hopefully the trails won't get knocked all the way down to the gravel. But anyway, we'll see you guys up the trail, and thanks for joining me again. Thanks for all new subscribers too. So I did actually take the studs out of my tires. It only takes a half hour to do all four tires with a good drill. It takes no time really, but... And I put my little exhaust tip back on from 2R Racing. I think Cubby's used one of those too for his 700, but it really doesn't do much, just adds a little bit more bass to your bike. I just wanted to try an experiment just to see how it sounds on the camera, especially with my voice being muffled by a balaclava. Because if it's too bad, I'll replace the tip again. It says it adds horsepower. Oh yeah, well, apparently stickers can add horsepower too. More stickers a bike has, more horsepower it has. That's just a proven fact, scientifically. You know, it goes the same with things like performance pipes and slip-ons and things like that. You're not going to see barely any performance gain with the slip-on pipe. All it's going to do is make your bike louder. You know, a lot of people say, well, manufacturers claim 5-plus horsepower. Well, no, not at all. I don't believe that for a second. There are a lot of bikes out in the woods. A little bit of ice here and there, not too bad. Hitting some water though. Again, hope my brakes don't freeze. They shouldn't. I got them soaked in WD-40 for like a water repellent, so. And I got a can with me. And that little bottle, a squirt bottle of methyl hydrate that I usually carry, I got that full. Poured some in my tank. I was just talking to a friend of mine back there at the start point. He said that he's got a Grizzly 700 that something froze up on him this morning, gas line or something. It's a hell of a time to try to get it going. Snow. Actually supposed to flurry all day and then maybe change to rain this afternoon. Not liking the whole rain thing, but we'll see what goes on. Kind of into it now. No turning back. I don't know why we just came to, we all came to a screeching halt right here for some reason. And again, it's just like car traffic, really. You get a bunch of cars on the road, there, you know, be no accidents or nothing like that, but it's just at a crawl. That highway up there is the 103, heading out towards Yarmouth, Bridgewater, Yarmouth, all that area down there. Bridgewater. I wonder if the guy up ahead of me is thinking I'm talking to myself. Probably. He's got something hanging off his trailer hitch or something, like a bag or something. Not really a good spot to keep that. At least all the water rolls are all busted out for the ice. I said it before, man, I'll say it again. My God, busting through ice on an ATV through the water holes like that, it is some hard on a bike. Bent A-arms, tie rod ends, pop yeah, I guess broken U-joints too. But yeah, I've seen some pretty bad carnage. Thank you. People stopped everywhere, man. I guess DNR is having quite the ball today. Department of Natural Resources, because they're out here in the run, and I don't know if they got their bikes here, but apparently from what I've heard, they're cracking down on ATV plates and everything like that, because see, in Nova Scotia, the way that Advance has everything done up for the year is when you pay your registration each year for your plate, you get that little sticker. You see, buddy's plate ahead of me. Anyway, it's only good for a 1 year, of course, but it ends in December, no matter what month you buy it in. So, of course, this being kind of mid-January, they're thinking that everybody should already have their plates all done up. Well, you know what? The sticker's not on my plate right now because it hasn't come in. So, you know, they're just, they're not being dicks, but at the same time, they are. I mean, give some people some leniency. I mean, especially with a rally this big, I mean, it's just ridiculous. They know that people can't outrun them. I don't know. They're getting more and more harsh every day. They're even charging people for things that they can't really charge them for. And people are going to court and their cases are being thrown out. So, justice system at its best, I guess. Trails are actually pretty good. A little bit of snow covered up a lot of the rocks that are out this way, because we are on the south shore, close to the ocean, closer to the ocean. So you're gonna get a lot of rock, a lot of granite, a lot of hard ground. But the snow has been great, kind of a blessing right now. Listen to that little bit of an exhaust note with that tip on there. I like being able to hear my bike. Because of that snorkel right there, it's sometimes difficult to do it, because that kind of snorts. when you don't have this tip on and you have the quiet stock tip, you can't hear it really. And the little performance step that you get here from 2R Racing, all built with aluminum polished, it's not that loud. It just adds a bit more bass to your bike. I used to be a fan of loud pipes and everything like that, but they're just not worth it. They sound better on a V-twin anyway. I think I made the mistake of using my insulated work boots, because I'm warm, the very tips of my toes are cold, right where the steel toes are. That's probably my bad, my mistake. Oh well, warm up once I start walking around again and stop, take a break somewhere. Snow squall. Bikes out in the woods, man. you can't even be bothered to wave to anybody. Your arm would be tired. Yeah, you go through the woods, you get that little, hey, how you doing, wave. What a cluster bomb of bikes and people, man. Look at that thing. Starting to warm up significantly now. It's probably only about -2. No sign of the rain yet. That's good. So I wanted to get out a bit early, but we got a late start, so. Fire extinguisher on that Razor, man. Everybody should have a fire extinguisher. Small, something small like that. They make them smaller than that one, too. Start carrying a small one for myself in the summertime. Because you just never know, man. Always good to have one. Rough section. That Razor up ahead says pounding through it. On rails. A little bit slippery without the studs on there, but there's lots of snow down, so. Ooh, not there. That's ice. Coming through here. plan. This is nice. Somebody's property. Seems that new 900's only got two speeds, off and bah. He likes hearing those pipes he's got on it. For staying dry, even the brakes dry. Lots of little floating nuggets get in your A-arms and stuff and beat up your CV joints. If that's the same river we passed before. Nice looking. It's warmed up again significantly. I dare say that it may be rain this afternoon. This evening. That was uncalled for. Hope it didn't soak the guy behind me. He was riding kind of close. Probably gonna get a lot icier than this for the last part of the rally. Oh, missed the bridge. I don't think I want to go on that anyway. Having fun. Just a little cabin. Am I still recording here? Yeah, can't see the light. Oh, nice. Nice. Really nice. Couldn't read what it said. It's a little rough. melty coming through here. Shifter into the granny hole. A little bit easier on the old belt. Woo! Damn! Ice just wants to pull you. Again, my toes are the only thing that's cold, it's just the very tips. Old trail. Some hidden rocks in this stuff too, you gotta watch. See, every once in a while when the splash or the water comes out of the hole like what he just did, it exposes some rocks that he can't see but I can. Through with no detached limbs or flat tires, so we're good. Hard to believe we only gone 30 kilometers. I think this is about a 100K run. I am not exactly sure. But there's not a lot of road running here. There's mostly trails. which I like. That's the type of running that I like to do. Well, we're just ended up at the halfway point. I just had a hamburger or cheeseburger and some fries and fish and chips and everything like that. They got set up here. They got a little repair thing here. Need some oil, some studs, or whatever you want. So bikes. Still eating. Took a while to get my food. Oh, it's getting icy. Well, we're coming up almost to the end of the journey. Well, 3/4 point now. So camera's battery's on his last legs. Probably time for me to pick up another one, do a battery switch halfway whenever I see him running low or something like that. So it's been good so far though. I use this little camera quite a bit. Glad I got it. Well, I'll put it this way. I'm glad I got it because I got to talk to a lot of you guys, a lot of my subscribers, and you know, entertain you guys, and that's a goal of mine, so I appreciate it. Ooh, ice. It's kind of ditch banging here right now, one side to the other. What a nice trail this is. Jeez. So apparently we're into trails that we were in here before. And almost. Almost. Anyway, that's like you're saying, we were in the trails that we were in here before, and yeah, you get about 600-700 bikes through here. They're pretty damn chewed up now. This turned rough. Holy crap. Mother on the back of that, by the way. He just bounced off the seat. There, it's a bit better. Camera's starting to die. All part of the fun. Well, two things. One, the camera's gonna die. Two, we're almost there. So, I just wanna thank you all for joining me on this ride. Once again, this was the Shore Riders annual Fish and Chips Rally. So thank you very much, guys. I hope you enjoyed. Please like, comment, subscribe, and we'll see you next time. Ride Guy out.